The multitasking bar is an important part of navigating the iOS. If you double tap on the home button, that's the hardware button at the bottom of your iPad, iPod Touch, or iPhone, as you can see, the home screen will slide up, revealing the multitasking bar. This shows all of your most recently launched applications. And if you swipe your finger from right to left, you'll see that it will reveal the next page of apps. If you had recently launched even more applications, you'd see those there as well. You can swipe back to that first page, and then if you swipe left to right one more time, you'll reveal the media controls. The media controls allow you to control your music playing. Starting at the right, you'll see the iTunes icon. That will actually be whatever your most recently used music playing application was. Now that I've launched iTunes, I can go back to the multitasking bar by simply swiping up with all four fingers if I'm using the multitasking gestures, or again double-tapping on the home button. And then I can swipe back over to the playback controls. To the left of the music icon, you'll see your standard volume controls. And then to the left of that, you'll find your AirPlay controls. If you don't see any AirPlay controls on your device, that's because you don't currently have an AirPlay device on your network. This button will automatically show up whenever something like an Apple TV is present on your network. To the left of that, you'll see your standard play, next, and previous shuttle controls for playing music. Then you'll see the screen brightness control. This allows you to manually control the brightness of your screen. Most of the modern iOS devices will actually control brightness automatically. However, if at any time you'd like to manually take over that, you can do that here. Finally, on the very left, you'll see the mute button. This can also be set up as the rotation lock button. Depends on how you have your preferences set. By default, it's set up to mute.